Jachaktayo vadataham vadinaham vai Vibad sangbad bhubo bhavanti Kurvanti chaisham muhuratma moham Tasmai namananta gunayavamne Jachaktayo vadataham vadinaham vai Vibad sangbad bhubo bhavanti Kurvanti chaisham muhuratma moham Tasmai namananta gunayavamne Gaudiya Goshthipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Gaudiya Goshthipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, that logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Srila Prabhupada speaking, that if we are going to take shelter of altercation, logical interpretation, in that case, you cannot have the opportunity to meet with that absolute truth. In fact, the absolute truth can vanish in front of you. Absolute truth cannot stand in front of you. Just when you grow your argument, logic, then absolute truth vanishes in front of you. The example I can give from Upanishad, very nice. Actually, Parabrahma, nobody can say we know Parabrahma totally. From different angle, though Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnava, Muni, Rishi, they are trying to understand. But nobody can say, I know Parabrahma totally. Nobody can say. Impossible. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, this sky is infinity, so a bird can fly on the sky, go up according to its own capacity. Bird can fly, okay. Maybe this bird cannot fly up to that far. A vulture can go up to that far. So different kind of birds, according to their air capacity, storage capacity, they are flying and reaching up to that point. Nobody can say, we cross this ocean, you know, sky. Impossible, unlimited, unending. Actually, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, just the same example Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking, that we are all trying our best according to the kripa of Supreme Lord. Up to this point we can know, after that we cannot know. So, but Premi Bhakta, those who are staying inside Vrindavan, this is not applicable for them. Anyway, I can come to this point after. But the example I want to cite from Upanishad is that Asur, Devasur Sangram, big fighting was there between, always going on. Those demons and those demigods. And by chance those demigods, they come out successful. Then Indra become very puffed up. Oh, we are getting victory over those, you know, those demons. They are defeated. Oh, foolish. After that, he is going to express his power. False ego. Khatanga Raja, or so many incidents we know. Babruvahan, they are all helping demigods. Many times we can go through Bhagavad carefully can see. They cannot fight with those demons. They invite Khatanga Raja, please come, help us. We cannot. Then they go and they fight and they help. Many times we see this kind of case happen, but still, Indra Maharaj thinking that I am the king of heaven, Who are you? I am the king of heaven. Really so? That's why in Chaitanya, in Bhagavat Mahatma, glorification of Bhagavat Mahatma, it is clearly written, Nacha Indrasya Sukham, Kinchinna Sukham Chakravartinaha, Sukham Asti Viraktasya Munir Ekanta Jivana. Who is happy? You think Indra is happy? No, no scope. Even cannot take wife with him. Oh, you stay, I am flying. Wife is there, helpless. This is the condition. But actually, this is the condition of heaven. So, nacha indrasya sukham, kinchinna sukham chakravartina. Indra, no happiness. Niravachinna, non-stop happiness. Eternal happiness is not there. Touching something. Okay, everybody busy with this kind of pain and pleasure, happiness, laughing, crying, all busy. What to speak the material history? All you known to you all. Now point is that where we can get satisfaction, where we can get dissatisfaction, if there is demand, there is dissatisfaction. If there is no demand, no dissatisfaction. Demand is the root cause of your dissatisfaction. But demand must be there. Transcendental demand. I need Krishna. Without Krishna, I can die. I will have to go serve him. I am fallen into this material world, unstable. We are foreigner here. You are foreigner? I am also foreigner. We are all foreigner here. Everybody foreigner, foreign place. We will have to go to the eternal world. So now Indra Bhagavan, Indra come out successful in this fighting. Why he become puffed up? Then Parabrahma, Paratvara Khileshwar wanted to give some lesson to him. Okay. Then in the gate of Sarga, he in the form of some peculiar jiva is there. Appear. Oh, who is looking at what is it? What is this? We never see. Who? Everybody become stunned. What is this? We never see. What? Ugly looking, what is that? Jakhya. After that, Indra got information. After the Indra sending, you know, you already know. Indra sending Bayudev, Bayudevata, Pavandev, to go and take information. You go as a messenger and take him, what is this? You're going asking. After that, well, who are you? Then that Jakha, yeah, that Parabrahma in the form of Jakha speaking, who you are? I am Pavandev. You don't know me? Oh, no, I don't know. I'm very powerful. I can take everything, like, you know, within fraction of seconds. Really so? You are so powerful. Giving one piece of straw. Could you please, you know, take away this? You cannot do. Defeat. What is this? This way actually, Pavandev, Barundev, Agnidev also. Agnidev ultimately, who are you? Putting question by the order of Indra to take information who is. I can burn up everything. You don't know. My name is Agni. Very powerful. Oh, really? You can burn up this, you know, straw, please. Could you please? Not successful. This way, they go back. After that, Indra was very interested. Yeah, all my parikar, they cannot take information. They are so powerful. What can be the reason? Let me go. He's coming in front of that. Strange, peculiar, you know, Yakya and asking. In the meantime, disappear. When he coming to take information with inquisitive attitude, then the Brahma, Parabrahma, disappear. But he find one aerial voice and looking up, oh, Uma. Uma. Gyanmayi, Gandhaini Uma. Sannidhi. Speaking is Parabrahma. Parabrahma? Yes, Parabrahma. You are just popped up. That's why I came here to test you. Don't try to express any kind of, you know, vanity. All done by Supreme Lord, Brahma, Paratpar, Akhileshwar, directly or indirectly, everything done by Supreme Lord. Everything done by Supreme Lord, nothing can be done by anybody. So this is the case. The sloka I started with is very important sloka from Bhagavatam. Yat sakta yo vadatam vadinam vai vivad sangvad bhuvo bhavanti kurvanti chaisham muhuratmamoham tasmai nama anantagunaya bhumne anantagunaya bhumne bhumne. I am going to pay dandavad. Because is one kind of magic spell, maya. All pandita, they are fighting with each other. They cannot come into any kind of conclusion. You can come into conclusion? I started with the point with Prabhupad, you know, told. As soon as you are going to take help of your logic, as soon as you are going to grow your argument, then the absolute truth vanishes from there. You cannot get. So this is not the way. You will have to follow Srauta Parampara. There is a system. So we find different kind of pandit there fighting with each other. But we know already from Mahabharata everywhere. Tarko apatishto srutayo vivinya naso munirjasya matam navinyam dharmasya tattam nihito guhayam nihitam guhayam mahayono mahayano jeno gatu sapantaha. In Vedanta Sutra also we are getting one same sloka. Tarko apatishtanat Vedanta Sutra tarko apatishtanat. Your tarko, altercation, your fighting, logical, no, you cannot stand. Tarko apatishto, sruto yo vivinya, different kind of sruti, siti, pura, speak. It is written there, it is written here. So I cannot tell you. I cannot tell you. It is written there in Taittiriya Upanishad. In Isha Upanishad, big problem. Nana sastha vichara naiko nipuno saddharma sangsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibhavane manyo saranya kyaro. Then, that is why na all Tattvavidha Acharya, they are coming to help me. Why coming there? To help me, to get the target very easily. Sra miggo sevasam pantaha santapa varjitaha anavapta samam jeno svantaha purva purva pratasthir purvam santam pratasthir. This is the sloka. So we'll have to take shelter of actually Srauta Pantha, but there is big fighting going on different place about Tattva, origin Tattva. There is big fighting always. Different ground fighting going on. Somebody is speaking, Supreme Lord is there. Somebody is saying, no, Supreme Lord not there. No, no, Supreme Lord where? No, nothing. Buddhist, they are speaking all zero. Shunno, Shunnavad. Mayavadi Vichar speaking, not directly speaking shunno, but indirectly speaking shunno. Formless Brahma, powerless Brahma. I can go on discussing some points related to my previous discussion, very important. Though it will take vast time, big time, huge time. But what to do, I will have to touch. So somebody is speaking, Supreme Lord is there. Somebody is speaking, no, no, nothing. or at all going to confess this Brahma is there, but formless Brahma, powerless Brahma. Now, we know from Tarka Shastra that if at all one thing is not there, if at all the existence, there is no doubt about the existence of that thing, because it is not there at all. For this kind of thing, again it is there or not, this kind of contradiction cannot come. You follow what I mean to say? What is not at all there? What is not at all there? For that object, but that thing, again the question of it is there or not, this question cannot come, because it is not there. Because sometimes we are speaking, Ghoda Dim, Asadimba. Asadimba not there. What do you mean by Asadimba? The egg of horse is not possible. Shasha Singo, hare, khargosh, you know? Have any horn? No horn. Sasa Singa or Asadimbo, horse egg, or useless. Because everybody knows it's not possible. Shonar Pathorvati, a pot made of stone, but still golden. How possible? If golden, then stone not possible. If made of stone, how possible golden? Shonar Pathorvati, we say. This way, so now actually some going to believe that Supreme Lord is not there. Some going to express this kind of, okay, if Supreme Lord is at all there, no headache. Or if Supreme Lord is not there, no headache. What is concern to us? If Supreme Lord at all there, what headache? If Supreme Lord not at all there, what headache we have? Huh? What it concerned to me? Oh, I am leading my nice life. This way. Another group speaking, Supreme Lord must be there. Supreme Lord is there. So three groups there. This way fighting going on. I can give one example through which you can get this point clear. Those who are speaking Supreme Lord is not there, they are foolish. Because what is not at all existing, that kind of object, we cannot again fight with this, on this topic, that the Supreme Lord is there or not, can be there, cannot be there. Because one example is more than sufficient, that some person is going outside, Varanasi, for 1 month gone, somebody coming to search him, whether he is there at home or not. Then from inside somebody's relative speaking, son or somebody, he is not there. He is not there doesn't mean that he is not at, that man is not at all existing there. He is not there doesn't mean that man is not at all staying there. That doesn't mean. For the timing is not there. Follow? Like evening now, evening time is not coming. That doesn't mean evening time cannot come. Evening time can come. So this way, this kind of argument cannot stand. Arthat, what I mean to say, I mean that man gone somewhere, he can come back again. So this can be. So that man is not there doesn't mean that man is not existing at all. Existence of man is there, that's why the inquiry coming, that man is there or not, this kind of, so Brahma is there. So this way actually fighting going on. Now those Mayavadis, they are actually in Chaitanya Charitamrita written, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking this way to give us one warning. Ved mukhe mayabad bauddha ke odhik. Ved mukhe mayabad bauddha ke odhik. For the time being, Shankar Abhadas was very important for the time being. That time it was very important for Sankha to come. Actually, to establish at least Veda, existence of Veda, because those Buddhists, they want to, you know, erase everything, the total existence of Veda. At least this privilege was there, facility was there. The Shankaracharya came and wanted to establish. Veda is there. Who can say? This kind of facility was there, but it is not ultimate facility. So, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak that Ved Mukhe Mayabad Bauddha Ke Udik. It is more dangerous. That keeping Veda in front is going to prove something which is very dangerous. Because common people, they cannot get any clue. They are in danger. Like if I want to prove that I am Guru Sevak, but secretly I want to use the name and fame of Guruji to get some advantage, name, fame, position. Common people, they are foolish, they are running behind me, they don't know. They are going to worship me, wash my little feet, they think I am devotee. But I am going to cheat them, they don't know. Follow what I say. So openly at all, if it is known to public that I am a demon, it's facility, very nice. But if people are going to believe me as a devotee, at the same time there is no devotion inside my heart, all problem there, all mayavad there, because I don't believe Guru Vishnu at all, or at all believe something, want to take advantage, is also demonic activities, big problem then. So it is written there, Mahaprabhu speaking, Ved Mukhe Mayavad Bauddha Ke Adhik. It is more dangerous than Buddhism. Because in Buddhism, openly we can see, they don't believe Ishwar. Shunyavad, they don't believe. So better we can control ourselves, we cannot go there. But how to understand that they are actually going to use Veda? They want to prove we believe. Maybe they are weak devotee, maybe, who can know? This way, Mahaprabhu speaking, Ved Mukhe Mayavad Bauddha Ke Adhik. You can remember some discussion took place between between Prakasananda Saraswati and Sriman Mahaprabhu in Varanasi. First of all, I would like to project some facts in front of you. What is the basic of Mayavad? What is the basic thing of Mayavad? The basic thing of Mayavad is to disbelieve Guru Vaishnav, the eternal existence and Bhagavan. Bhagavan Naam, Dham, Parikar, Vaishishta, Supreme Lord, all fictitious. Even the material existence, what you see, phenomenal world, also useless. Oh, it's a dream. They are speaking this way. So basic thing of this Mayavad is to prove that there is nothing. Supreme Lord is, you know, impersonal Brahma, nothing. No Shakti is there. This way they always want to pick up some sloka from Upanishad and Vedanta. This they like to choose some sloka. And they want to prove that, you see, it is written in Upanishad. It is written in Vedanta. Oh, no, it's impersonal Brahma. Like they are speaking, Tattva Mosi. Tattva Mosi, Tattva Mosi mane Tattva Mosi. They want to prove only Brahma is there, nothing is there. Jiva, no. No Jiva, who Jiva? No Jiva there. They are all Brahma. Brahma get distorted. So now in the form of this, it's one kind of dream. It's not. It's one kind of dream, nothing. It's not fact. So they say they want to prove this, this phenomenal world is false. Jivaiva brahmo na paraha, eko brahmo ditya nasti. Only one brahmo is there, second, nothing. Second nothing, no second object. That's why Shankaracharya is, you know, Darshan is for, is, Kebalad, Keba, but actually, Kebalad Daitabad. Kebalad Daitabad, Kebalad Daitabad, no Daita conception. No, 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 nothing, no dual conception can stand. Only Brahma is there. Nothing else. They want to pick up some sloka from here and there, Upanishad, like one from Tattvamasi. Hey, Jiva, they are counted. No, nothing. It's all Brahma. What they mean to say? Well, it is written in Upanishad, Tattvamasi. Tattvamasi means? Tvat, Tvam, Osi. Tvat, Tvam, Osi. Atat, you are that Brahma. You don't know? You are Brahma. Eka Brahma eva na paraha. Only Brahma is there. You Brahma. This way then. But our Gaudiya Darshan, as per Gaudiya Darshan, we can find exact meaning of this, you know, one sloka. Tattvamasi, they want to explain that way. But we Gaudiya Vaishnava, how we get this meaning? Tasya tam asi. Tasya Tvam asi. Tasya mane, you are his. I mean, you are all the servant of that supreme, you know, Brahma. Tasya tvam asi, not tattvam asi. Tattvam asi means tasya tvam asi. It's okay. Tattvam asi, okay, qualitatively okay. It's not 100% false, but they want to interpret different way. They want to take undue advantage of this sloka. It's true that qualitatively all okay. Brahma is Chinmay, Chit, and this is also Jiva, Jiva also Chinmay. Jiva also Chinmay, Chit particle, but he is Vibhu Chaitanya, Anu Chaitanya. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda was speaking, sometime you can see one jivatma, very small jivatma, chit particle, while doing bhajan, having some form, na, like human being, with the association of Guru Vaishnava doing bhajan. By chance the bhajan was very good. He was so successful, that now she can deliver the whole world, so powerful. That is why in Kirtan it is written, don't try to disbelieve. It is, that is why it is written, Brahmando Tarite Sakti Dhare Jane Jane. Not only all countless jivata jar existing in this material world, not that. Brahmanda. Countless jivas all over this Brahmanda. All. This sadhu, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Thakur Prabhupad, Bhakti Vinod, they can't, Samananda Prabhu, Srinivasa Acharya, Advaita, they can't deliver. They are not actually chit particle, I am giving example. Any small chit particle also, when getting contact with a pure sadhu, go on doing bhajan, they can also get this kind of power. Like one example given, like one inflammable object there, like kerosene, petrol there, follow, kept somewhere. Now by chance one spark of fire touch that inflammable object, follow what I mean to say. So, you follow what I am, you follow what I am. In that case, that spark is just, you know, can enter into the inflammable object and get the form of a big fire. Possible or not? That only is a spark. Now, in contact with that inflammable object, petrol or kerosene or the resin, now taking the form of huge is possible. So not that you can stay foolish infinity life. Not that you are going to lead your life like an idiot. Not that. You can also get that kind of power. You will have to keep hope. You will have to keep hope. You will have to foster. You will have to foster that kind of desire inside your heart to get power in future. Your subconscious mind covering 90% of your mind portion. Only 10% you are using daily, you doing job, playing your brain. Foolish, you don't know. Huge portion, 90%. If you are going to take determination, then what not you can do? You can do everything. Everything is possible. You can know past, present or future. Through your bhajan, you can look at anybody, can understand his heart. From distance, you can. All siddhi can come automatically. Money not going to everybody giving. Somebody giving, you know, almond, somebody giving, you know. Somebody giving, walnut, everybody giving. By Supreme Lord arrangement, we are not going to ask. By any way, we are going to offer to, you know, Supreme Lord and taking a prasadam, what to do. Sometimes distribution also. This way, by the desire of Supreme Lord, what not possible? If Jivatma is sincere, this point is very vital. If Jivatma is sincere, if Jivatma is sincere, if Jivatma is not sincere, then I cannot take risk. You are kapat, then I cannot take it. Only the thing you will have to do, that is, you will have to show your 100% inclination. That much you will have to do. Then all other qualities, Gurudev can give. All other qualities, Gurudev can. Yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai, tomara koruna sar. You know, you go through this kirtan. Yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai, tomara koruna sar. Sar means the only thing there. That we are expecting causeless mercy from you. That is much. But one thing, your vital responsibility there, that you will have to show. That's why Nityananda Tayasya, I can discuss this point. Yesham sa yesho Bhagavan dayayeda ananta sarvatmana sridhapadam yodi nirvalikam te dustaram atitaranta cha devamayam na mamahumiti sa sigala bhakshe. This look I can start. In Nityananda Trayadashi, you can understand that. So this way, maybe Jivatma is, you know, spark of the chit. But that chit, okay, but it coming in contact with inflammable object, can take a huge form, can get fire, power, and do everything. This way, actually, Tattvamasi, they are speaking this way, okay, qualitatively it's okay. It's not false, totally. Qualitatively, chit, chinmayatma, chit, chit, and Brahma is also vibhu chaitanya, it's okay. But, totally not perfect. But, because those chinmayivatma, those are teeny particles of the chinmay. So, they are actually, they will have to serve that object. They are eternal servant. I can come to this point regarding Jivatma Tattva, actually. Now, they want to prove that this phenomenal world is all false. And they want to prove that Brahma is just getting distorted and taking this form. Distorted? Brahma distorted? How you can say? Whereas in Brahma Sangita, everywhere we find Jat Brahma Niskalam Anantam Asesha Bhutam Govinda Madhi. How you can say? Huh? Like foolish? Jat Brahma Niskalam Anantam Asesha Bhutam. It is written there. Niskalam is stainless. Brahma is stainless. Never can undergo any kind of distortion. How you make Brahma distorted? Niskalam anantamashi. Pure all the time. So pure, so pure. Cannot expect. But you foolish, you are speaking that Brahma can get distorted. Ah, yes, distorted. They are not at all going to believe the Shakti of Brahma. They are not at all ready to accept this dual tattva. They think if we believe another tattva, this is Maya tattva, then we cannot maintain this, Kevaladvaitavad. No, Maya is not there. They think if we believe that there is one Shakti of this Brahma, then we are going to destroy the whole system of our, Kevaladvaitavad. Whereas our Achinta Vedabhat Tattva, I can go on discussing one point, one by another, time to time. Whereas Mahaprabhu giving argument to those Mayavadis, the leader of them is Prabhu Prakasananda Saraswati, that actually, how you can believe that there is no Shakti? But if Shakti is there, then only Brahma. But Mahaprabhu speaking, why not? Whereas in this material world we find that if one's touch stone is there, if we touch with iron or any metal, get converted into gold. Who not knowing? Even international scientific ground, all scientists, those who are not foolish, they are bound to believe that there is such kind of stone available. Not only that, our Sanatana Goswami already got this kind of stone. Touchstone. Those scientists, they believe it is 100% possible. Why not possible? Well, how possible? Yes, possible. Why not possible? There can be such magic spell, power of that touchstone, that when that stone is, stone coming in contact with iron, then maybe that stone having that kind of power to convert the molecular structure of that iron. Follow? It's possible. Why not possible? Whereas in chemistry, in periodic table, we find uranium, plutonium, rhodium, everything there. Jellio Curie, Madame Curie, the original, couple from England. They are very poor, very poor, very poor. They started doing research, which pitch blend. From one factory, they are going to throw pitch blend as waste product. And Chelio Guri, Madame Guri, husband and wife, used to collect it like ghost, You cannot have those under cultivation doing the, these are the farmer, they are not going to put this kind of energy. Oh, they are night, they are collecting, and they are, in fire, they are, they are trying to get, 1.1 milligram or milligram uranium. Oh, they are trying. Whole day and night, fire, they are trying to get this, filtering and trying to get this uranium. Ultimately, they are successful to get one very small piece of uranium. Very, put so much. In the chemistry, history of chemistry, nobody can forget their name. So much energy they put it. Follow? All scientists, they are all, they are going to, research, they are all grateful to them. So one day actually what thing happened? Madame Curie, Jellio Curie, in a table, the drawer was there. Inside was some film was there. Film? Don't know film? Really? Foolish? Without film, how you are getting picture? Film. Ah, the film. Film. Some raw film, black film was there. They got it for some reason. they put the flame inside, they put the flame inside the drawer. At the same time, the uranium piece and small piece were also there. And at morning time, they again start, after taking rest morning time, they again started with full energy to do that research. They open the drawer, find, oh my God, how it is spoiled. Husband and wife say, how possible? As they are developing some, you know, unwanted, some, you know, disturbance there in the flame. What? But some marking of light. Light? Where from light coming? We don't know. Again, next day they try. Again, it's the same thing. Then they thought it is possible that this, that small piece of uranium, it is radioactive element. It must be radioactive element. After later on life, we know that alpha, beta, gamma, this kind of three rays coming out of this radioactive element. Later on, how X-ray was possible? There. This way. X-ray, this procedure was successful. This way. Here have to stand. Then from backside, some ray can come. It can show you a picture of your bone or anything inside your body. This way. So it is proved. Mahaprabhu wanted to prove the why not possible. Whereas in this material world, we have evidence that if touchstone is there, a touchstone going to touch with the, when iron get converted into gold. Even Akbar Basa wanted to collect that piece of, you know, that jewel, spot some money, couldn't find. Because that madman whom Sanatana give, he throw into Jamuna, but not find. So in this procedure, scientists also going to believe 100%. Well, it is 100% possible. Why not possible? Maybe this kind of power is there with this stone, that while coming in contact with iron, can convert the molecular structure of that iron and can convert into gold. Whereas we know uranium piece, if you keep for long time, it can come down to the second level. Follow? When I was reading, that time uranium was topmost. But now I don't know, long time I am not reading chemistry, nothing, I don't know. Follow? They prove that when uranium is kept for long time, that uranium due to degradation, that come down to the second element. Uranium can be converted into rhodium, plutonium, different kind of. So if possible in periodic table, we have evidence, then why not possible? So Mahaprabhu speaking simply, so why you are speaking this way, whereas this material touchstone can have that kind of magic spell power, whereas you are not going to believe that Brahma can have that kind of power, whereas that Brahma can remain intact. Why you are going to explain that way? That Brahma Vikari, Brahma can get deformation? It's not good. We know when that piece going to change iron, but still sparsamani cannot change its own structure. Follow? Sparsamani not going to change, but it can change. This way Mahaprabhu giving example, and they cannot reply because they have no reply. How they can speak? They have no reply. So as per Achinta Vedavat Tattva, I was speaking yesterday while I was discussing Ramanuja Tattva, everything, I was discussing this point. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to accept Shakti Tattva, special Shakti Tattva from Ramanujaja to establish Achinta Vedavat Tattva? Are Vedavat was also already there. Vedavat was already there. Doita Doita Doitoman Vedavat is already there, Nimbarka Acharya. Nimbarka Acharya not only told, Madhava Acharya also many times I can show. It will take years to discuss. Madhava Acharya also sometime believing. Follow? So those Mayavadi want to take help of some sloka here from there, but that kind of meaning is local meaning. You know, local meaning? Local meaning. Mane going to that word has some meaning, but a local meaning, not overall meaning. That word going to express some local meaning. But overall discussion, if you do, you can come out with one conclusion which can give you, offer you one overall meaning. Follow? In Sanskrit, we say sarvadeshik or agdeshik. In Sanskrit, we say agdeshik, meaning local meaning. Agdeshik. And sarvadeshik meaning all Upanishads start and find this meaning, overall meaning. So, is this way actually, they are going to take undue advantage. So, Mahaprabhu speaking this way, and Dvaitaidvaita already Vedaved was already there. Nimbarka Acharya already established. Nimbarka Acharya wanted to establish this thing. But what is the new way with Gaudiya Math? Gaudiya Math means Gaudiya Siddhanta. What is the new? But the new is that, there is Achinto Vedaved. Achinto Vedaved. Achinto, one word used, prefix used by the indication of Mahaprabhu, Jiva Goswami produced Achinto Vedaved. Inconceivable. Your brain cannot go up to that far. Infinity jivas, they are going to play, get together and play their overall brain, still cannot come. Yato vachaha nivartante aprapo manasasaha. This Mahavadi says, Brahma cannot be known, foolish. Why they are coming to do bhajan? They are going to show this point. It is written that Brahma cannot be known. Where it is written? Well, it is. Yato vacho nivartante aprapo manasasaha. It is written there. Mind and speech all can come back with a feedback. Come back. Cannot come out successful. So you leave all your effort to do, to know the Brahma. Brahma can never be known. Never been? Why? But you say speech or different, then what do you mean to say? All scripture, everything not going to indicate? What do you mean to say? Whereas in Veda, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Vedascha sarvai rahamave vedyo. And you want to speak that all scriptural analysis, all any kind of evidence cannot prove that Brahma. Then why you are coming to do bhajan? Foolish. Whereas it is not possible for you to know Brahma. But Maharaj, when I become Brahma, how I can know Brahma? Bhaktivinoda give me an example, or Guru Varga. You want to test how sugar is, sweet ball is, because sugar is there, that's why sweet ball is very sweet. Now, if you want to make yourself sugar, then who is going to test a sugar ball, sweet ball? Follow what I mean to say? If myself I become sugar, who can test the taste of sugar? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they are foolish. That's why they are going to, when I become Brahma, how I can know the taste of Brahma? Not possible. All totally they are speaking false. We can prove one by one example. Yato vacho nivartante apravi. This sloka means material sound and material effort cannot come out successful. Material sound, material sabda, material effort cannot succeed. Sarvam Avartajaja also fighting with Mahaprabhu. It is written. No hands and leg of Supreme Lord is written. Apani Pado Javan. Apani Pado written. No hands and leg. Apani Pado Javano Grihita. After that, it is written. So many things it is written. Apanibad, no hands and leg, nothing there. Pashatiya Chakshu, Srinatiya Karno. No eyes, but looking everything. No ears, but hearing everything. How possible? Sarma Vataji would say, it is written. Brahma, no ear, no eyes, nothing. That's why na Jadavacharya started speaking like a demon. Comparing the beauties of the lotus feet, lotus eyes of Vishnu with the backside of monkey. Oh, idiot. Foolish. Ananta Sundar, Ananta Khil Ras Bhagavan, you know? So he is going to compare. The Mayavadi. They have no belief. So this way actually, Apanipad Mahaprabhu wanted to prove. I already published one book approved by Prabhupada. All the detailed discussion of Vedanta with Mahaprabhu and Sarvam Bhattacharya. Nila Achale Vedanta Vekhya. Who can translate? We need to translate very fast, so many things. Rare, but nobody there. We have to do. So this way you see, Mahaprabhu wanted to prove, okay, well, Apanipad is there, but at the same time, next point, Javano Grahita, no hands and leg, but quickly coming and accepting. If there is no hands and leg, who is coming first to accept? Javano means very fast, like more than wind. Apanipada, Javano Grahita. Hands and leg not there, but still coming fast to accept. Out of your love, what do you mean to say? What do you mean to give? And there is no eyes, but still can see everything. No ears can see everything. Can hear everything. Yeah? That's why we can find one nice sloka in Brahma Sangita, na? Yasendriyani, jasendriyo sakalavi. I forget this sloka. Sakalendriya vittimanti pasanti panti kalayanti jiram jaganti. He said. Jasendriyo sakalendriya vittimanti pasanti panti kalayanti jiram jaganti. Any of his sense organ can discharge the duty of another organ. Hand can eat. Eyes can eat. Hand can see. What do you mean? Foolish. No. It is written. Document. Indriyani yasso sakalindya vittimanti. Any of his organ is full of power of all other organs. Or which you can expect from other organ, still can, hand can do. Hand can look. Why not possible? Why not possible? How is possible? Yes, possible. Why not possible? I already give you an example, maybe 2 years back. I forget. There one snack is a name of snack. Okhisroba. Okhisroba. One name of snack is Okhisroba. Mine can hear through eyes. Huh? Hear through eyes? Yes. The snack can both. Can do both through by the help of eyes, can see, can hear. No separate hearing organ. When some vibration there, the vibration coming through ear and touching here, they can understand somebody coming, they fly. Follow? This way, if we find this kind of excellency there, in this material world, then, if a snake having that kind of power, he can utilize his eyes to hear something, why you cannot believe that the Supreme Lord can do anything but kartum akartum anyata kartum ya samartaha saishwaraha? You cannot believe? Foolish. So Mahaprabhu giving this kind of example to Sarvamvatajajo. Ultimately, Sarvamvatajajo was defeated. He was bound to confess bhakti. And ultimately, Mahaprabhu, when Sarvamvatajajo got the chance to see the full fish, you know, beautiful Nitya Sarup of Supreme Lord, then Sarvamvatajajo gone mad, feel unconscious. Because the power of the darshan of Supreme Lord, you cannot resist. That kind of power is not there. Follow what I mean to say. You don't believe me. Actually, if I want to use one aluminium cable and want to pass very heavy voltage, immediately you can find that aluminium, this, you know, this can melt up. Cannot resist. Follow? That kind of heavy power, that aluminium, you know, cable cannot resist. Similar example I can say, the kind of chit power there already there in you, maybe you are doing bhajan. It's impossible. When Supreme Lord coming in front of you, you cannot bear. You can shake. What power? Supreme Lord coming. Inconceivable. This way, actually, Sarvamvatajajo gone mad, faint. After that, Mahaprabhu touch, give consciousness, getting back consciousness, Mahaprabhu speaking. Before speaking, Sarvamvatajajo started doing, speaking stotra, hundreds of stotra, hundreds of sloka. After finish, Mahaprabhu bless. Shato slok kori more jekoile stavan. You are going to glorify me through hundreds of sloka. Readily you are making. Not sitting and making some effort. No, readily. Like wind speaking. No mistake was there. No mistake was there. Because by that time, already all vanity, false ego gone. Why mistake was not there? Whereas that, you know, Digvijay Pandit, he is also not a matter of joke. Keshav Kashmiri, he become in his, you know, sampradaya, he become big acharya. What is the case? He is also great pandit, but still he could not make pure sloka. Viruddhamati, bhagnakram, different kind of grammatical terms can be used. Mahaprabhu speaking. You are making different kind of mistake. Impossible. Impossible not. Can show you. Now my question is that why Digvijay Pandit could not make pure sloka? Whereas Saraswati is sitting here. Whereas Sarvamvatajajo could make pure sloka. No addition, alteration, no need of any editor. Why? First point is that Digvijay Pandit, that time, he was full of false ego. False ego means ignorance. In front of Supreme Lord, if you go to show you, project you, whereas you are ignorant, then double mistake you can make. Follow, I find. But by that time, when Sarvamvatajajo wanted to explain this, glorify, by that time, all false ego gone. Already receiving the kripa of Mahaprabhu, Swarup of Mahaprabhu. So there was no mistake. Follow what I say. This way actually, those Mayavadi, they want to prove that Shakti we cannot believe. Mahaprabhu giving away, why not possible? Shakti, you can believe Shakti. But if you believe Shakti, then dual conception can come. We can break our, you know, pillar of Mayava Siddhanta. Not. Prakasananda Saraswati was bound to confess, you are Narayan, you are Lakshman, we are all symptom, we see you are just like Narayan. What you speak? All perfect. There cannot be any doubt. There cannot be any doubt. Why we are going to, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to give some value to Ramanuja Siddhanta? Why? Because in Ramanuja Siddhanta there is a vital point. Visishtadvaitabad, I can discuss some point, I can touch, but day by day we'll have to discuss. So many points. Fast. The main point I like to touch, Ramanuja Siddhanta, why it is called Visishtadvaitabad? Visishtadvaitabad, why? Because Ramanuja is going to speak this jivas, all countless jivas, and this, you know, nature, prakriti, everything, or creation, it proves, has some special evidence that Brahma is in the form of this. Brahma need not take, Brahma can, Brahma mean, but Ramanujacharya speaking one vital point, Brahma need not bear any distortion. Ramanujacharya speaking, Brahma need not undergo any distortion. Ah, vital point. Really so. That the thing we get by the mercy of Mahaprabhu. Shakti Siddhanta, right you are. Visishtadvaitabad mean all the besides the speciality. Brahma we cannot see. But Brahma, when jiva, all jivas and his material world we see, is one in Bhagavatam also. Bhagavan is sthula rup. Sanskrit, you know? Sthula rup. The verse, you know, material world is one kind of sthula rup. Sthula mean? Expanded form. Sthula rup, material rup. This Parvat, Bhagavatam in the second skanda. In second skanda, all those clouds is the hair of Supreme Lord. Is written there. Is written. All those, you know, hills and, you know, this way, different kind of evidence, you know. Those briksha, trees, those are the, you know, hair, body hair of Brahma. Bhagavatam is there. So, Ramanujacharya going to establish Visishtadvaitabad, I mean that we can get some vishesh speciality of Brahma through jivas and prakriti, I mean this nature creation. So it is Visishtadvaitabad. And this Shakti Tattva was accepted by Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu wanted to choose one by one point from four different sampradayas to prove that Achinta Vedavet Tattva is the final through which you can get all harmony. Scientifically, all of you, four acharyas lacking some or other point. Scientifically, all of you, all four acharyas, they are lacking slight points, lacking. So Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, wanted to take one point from four acharyas, wanted to prove, oh, you are almost okay, but this point was not applicable. That's why we put one word, that is achinta, inconceivable. Achinta mean inconceivable. But you don't know. Achinta mean Gaudiyas, they are going to explain very sweet way. Achinta not only mean that it is inconceivable. Achinta not only means that is inconceivable. Achinta means that there is another ground platform where your brain cannot reach. Only love, prema can reach. There is rasamai ground where all you can adjust, get adjusted harmony. Follow what I say. Achinta means there is another platform where if you where you can reach, if you can reach, you can find more Maharaj, all harmony, no doubts are there. Hake? Rasa ground. On the basis of topmost rasa tattva, if you go, you can find Maharaj, everybody harmonized. I have no doubts. I have no fighting, nothing. Follow what I say. So, from Ramanuja Acharya, Mahaprabhu wanted to take this point, what is Shakti Tattva, is same thing what our Gaudiya Vaishnava is speaking. Brahma Shakti taking in this taking the form of this actually non-different from Brahma, okay, same thing. But Ramanuja is speaking, Brahma need not undergo any kind of distortion. Brahma can stay intact. This is the vital point, na? Mahaprabhu wanted to prove. So why not? I can discuss some point also from Ramanujacharya, but not now. Why Mahaprabhu going to touch Madhvacharya's vital point? What is the vital point of Gaudiya Bhajan? That they believe and love Sachidananda Sarup. Iswaraha, Sachidananda Vigraha. Anadiradi Krishna, Anadiradi Govinda Sarva Karanaka. Follow? Sachidananda Vigraha, the vital point. They are also somehow going to believe, but Sachidananda Vigraha, this point is specially approved in Madhvacharya Sampradaya, which is the vital of Gaudiya Sampradaya. Of course, Ramanuja also, Paro, Buho, Orcha, Vibhav, all Ramanuja is speaking. Not that approval is not there. But still, the special approval is there in Madhu Sampradaya. These two are the vital points on the basis of which Mahaprabhu wanted to accept this point from Madhvacharya, this point from Ramanujacharya. Now again I go back to this Mayavad Tattva to disprove their power, to disprove their, you know, their all Tattva Siddhanta, useful, useless. So Mayavad is, they somehow wanted to prove that Brahma getting distorted and taking this form. And they are also speaking Jiva Bhammaiva Naparaha. In Sankara Sampradaya, we can find Gaurpad is Shankaracharya's Gurudev, his Gurudev Gaurpad. So there is one story going on there in their Sampradaya. The Gaurpad came, took form, and Shankaracharya also. Shankaracharya was the second Shankaracharya, they took body, form. Now our point is that you are number one liar. Why you are speaking this way? You say the Jivatma, when living body is submerged in Brahma, and now you become Brahma. How it is possible from Brahma again you come back and take different birth? Again, a second birth? Follow how they are liar. Liar number one. In their Sampada, I had this story going on. Second body. A second body, how possible? If you already submerged in Brahma, then Brahma is not possible to come back. Liar number one, don't speak that way, you are a liar. Ramanujacharya speaking that jivas, they are, when they are doing this kind of bhajan to go, Ramanujacharya gives an example, there is dense forest. Ramanujacharya giving this example. Suppose there is dense forest, some flock of birds, you know, that morning time, cheep, 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 doing green color, you know? Green color, no? Tiapaki, we speak. When a flock of that a bird entering into forest, outwardly were gone. Because all dense forest is also blue, green, deep green. Green, no? Their color is also green. Eh? They cannot see. Follow what I say. Ramanuja speaking, it is not possible for them to get so much. Brahma is Brahma, and they are going to maintain their own existence also. Visishta Dvaitavad. Ramanuja is going to speak Shuddha Dvaitavad. Shuddha Dvaitavad. Vishnuswami is speaking Shuddha Dvaitavad. Follow. Vishnuswami is speaking. Vishnuswami is speaking this. Madhava is speaking Shuddha Dvaitavad. Vishnuswami is speaking Shuddha Dvaitavad. And Nimbarka is speaking Dvaita Dvaitavad. All one by one, some special point we discuss. You can see all you can harmonize by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What not possible to understand? What not possible for you to understand? Everything is possible. The Supreme Lord is going to give me Kipa. Gurudev, Vaishnava, Prabhupad, Bhakti Muttayav, Kesav, Maharaj, Gurudev, all possible to understand. What? Madhava Acharya going to establish so many points. Within that, Madhava Acharya going to prove that Shuddha Dvaitavad, never in infinity period, Brahma is always separate, Jiva is always separate. No, always. Even in Mukta form, when they become Mukta, still they are separate. Shuddha Dvaito. Dvaito means dual conception. For pure dual conception. No. Madhava Acharya is speaking. Madhava Acharya is saying five different kinds of Veda is approved in their sampradaya. Jiva, 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 Jada, Jada, Jada. Ishware Bhagavan. Ishware Jive. Follow. You try to understand. Ishvara Jiva. Ishvara Jiva, Jiva Jiva, Jiva Jada, Jada Jiva. All five I can prove. Next day, very interesting. Madhava speaking, all this difference, always there. This kind of speciality always there. When we are going to prove this thing, na? Eh? The Jiva Tattva? Then we can also take help of this Madhava Acharya. Actually, all our Guru Varga, Jiva Goswami Pad, our, you know, Baladev Vidwas, they all, who not? Sanatana Goswami, they are all going to give honor to Madhava Acharya. You can discover some disparity. I also wanted to give some argument why Siddhanta Vichar, so that you cannot grow your separate conception from Madhava Acharya, Vriddha Vaishnava. Before writing Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami was speaking, oh, excuse me, I am going to take help. I am going to, you know, understand everything given by Vidva Acharya, Madhava Acharya. I am going to take conclusion from them by the help of this Madhava Acharya. Siddhanta is the basic of all Sandarbha. This way, anyway, Mayavad cannot, the Sankar Sampradaya can never prove, cannot stand. They cannot stand. That is why, na, when Ramanujaja wanted to explain that way, Jadavacharya wanted to kill. Jadavacharya wanted to kill that student, because it can be big danger in my life. It is a history. Traditional history. Those who are Mayavadi, maybe they are in the form of Vaishnav, Tilak, Mala, everything, Acharya, nice. But still, they want to kill pure Guru Vaishnav, throw Guru Vaishnav. Huh? They want to prove they are not Vaishnav. Then you can understand they are Mayavadi. How you know? Baba speaking, if you go through Bhagavatam Purana, you can see it is the target of Jarasandha to kill Krishna. Finish. Is it a target of Kamsa to finish? It's a big problem. There should not be any fountainhead. kill Krishna. Somebody going to Ravan, want to abduct Sita, Shakti. It is also Mayavadi. Mayavadi? Some Mayavadi want to abduct Shakti, try to make Parabrahma devoid of Shakti. That is also Mayavad. Another group want to kill Supreme Lord. Yeah, finish. No problem can stand. Also Mayavad. All Mayavad, dangerous Mayavad. So we must be very careful from Mayavad. How to understand who is Mayavadi? If you are sincere, if you are sincere, if you are sincere, then Balaji Maharaj is going to help you through Guru Vaishnava. To help you, don't go there, come here. You are going to calculate, Maharaj, 1 lakh people is a viewer of this video. Okay. So what? So what? If there is one pros going to dance, there are thousands, lakhs of people watching. That doesn't mean it is Harikatha. You cannot prove. That is why Pope was speaking, don't go there, come here. I know you like to go there to hear sweet, sweet philosophy. Come here. I like to save you all. Don't go there. I know you are feeling disturbed. Please come here. You can get lost. So my power is limited. How I can save you all? Up to what far my voice can go? I don't know. But I'm sure those who are going to hear one voice, one time, with some respect, someday they can get some way out. If they are going to disbelieve me, if they are going to hate me, I am not feeling any disturbance, but in that case I cannot put any guarantee in front of them that they can get benefit. Same Siddhanta Baba speaking, sometime we are hearing, attending big, big Vaishnavas, hearing Harikatha, still we cannot get any benefit. I can discuss this point next day. Follow. Today I already started writing one comparative statement of, you know, four sampradayas. Like wind. But still I cannot complete. That's why I couldn't open this, see. Like wind, I'm writing from morning time, you know. Time. But still it will take long time. But if you can publish it in the form of books, very interesting. Very interesting, everybody can enjoy, because it's very typical. Nobody knows Ramanuja. What Siddhanta name? Shuddha Daito. We seem all same. Daita, Daita, Shuddha Daito, all same. Yes. What is the difference? You cannot understand. So you will have to concentrate your mind. If you can concentrate your mind, then you can become genius. How you can become genius? So many intelligent people there, they cannot concentrate. Not possible. Chanchal all the time. Sa migraha sayasam hetuhu pantha santapa varjitaha anabapta samam purve jeno santo pratasthire. I already spoke this slok. I already spoke, na? Speaking many times. What does slok mean? Sa migraha sayasam pantha santapa varjitaha anabapta samam purve yeno santo pratasthire vancha kalpadarvasya ke pasand bhavacha patitanang pavanabhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namo. So any question if you have? No question. Why no question? That means you are not going to understand. That's,
Someone sent this question. Identify ourselves as a Gaudiya. Is to be Gaudiya also one identification?
Yeah, to be Gaudiya one identification, but it is pure identification. Naham Vipra Nachan Narapati Napi Vishwana Sudra, this kind of sloka, Mahaprabhu speaking, don't try to identify yourself with the help of Maya. Varnasam Dharma is also one kind of indirect Maya. So also we'll have to throw it. Varnasam Dharma we cannot keep. Eternally we cannot maintain. Up to certain point, throw. So it matters little. So it matters little that you are from Russia, she is from Italy, she is from, you know, America, it matters little. The matter is that how far, how much you are successful to come in front of pure Guru Vaishnava. How near to Guru Vaishnava you are coming. Because by the radiation of Guru Vaishnava, you can change your heart, mind, everything. Gradually you can feel your mind is transcendental. That's why na Radharani is going to teach us, Aner hidaye mon, mor mon bindavan, mone mone ak kari mani. This slok someday I explained before. You forget, foolish.
No, not my question.
Ah.
This is a question in one internet.
No.
Who is listening?
So actually you're listening, but point is that this is one kind of identity, but we need to get this kind of pure identity. That we are Gaudiya. I don't know how to identify. I already told. The Sahaja there and Navadip there, I don't know. We are following Gauramat, Gaudiya. What is the symptom of Gaudiya? You will have to preach up to the last breath. So that people, nobody can cheat common people. What is the symptom of Gaudiya? We want to arrange in such a way so that nobody can cheat. Stop cheating people. We can arrange. Broadcast, Mahaprabhu speaking. You will have to broadcast all about the absolute truth everywhere so that people can get right information. Follow, you see. So, sincere jivatmas, they can get some benefit, 100%. No doubt in it. Oh, I'm going to change. So, let them speak, so it matters little. Krishna bhajane nahi jatkuladi vichar. Jai bhaje sei varo abhakta hinchar. It is written. Not that I am from foreign country, I cannot get Krishna. Who told you? You are going to cross Mahaprabhu? No? Krishna bhajane nahi jatkuladi vichar. Jai bhaje sei varo. If you do bhajan, you can...